played Orianna all split. Jeez. It's a very intense engage option. Speaking of intense lock-ins, that's a Kayle.
The level of all-in is very high as the tie will take away Kayle's top lane pick here. In fact, maybe spend some gold fairly soon. And going to come back and see if he can't make it a bit more competitive.
And Zatai is just desperate to get level 6 so that the burst combo is no longer available there for Tristana in terms of getting a kill. No CC to actually interrupt the trades coming through. Zatai's taking a lot of damage.
Oh, beast. That's a good flashlight coming through. It's a Trumper, though. Actually got a bubble onto Kid that started that whole...
...leading into aggressive turret dives with the flag and drag CC.
First blood actually happens in the bottom side. Crystal with Ella. Kid down there by himself. Dies with his flash up under his turret. Found a very good way to keep this Trundle at least sedated, if not down.
It's one of the things that Zatai is uniquely able to do. It's one of the reasons they were so happy.
Gonna try and take their second dragon. Zatai will finally join in for a team fight here. But a good pillar of ice zones them away. IG trying to get some damage done, but Snake have plenty of good damage. Beast actually, four-man ulti coming through. Shockwave comes in as well. Hits onto two, and they're on the carries. Crystal goes in deep in the backline, trying to get resets. Gets one, will reset now. Good ult though from Rookie might push him out, but Kid's gonna go down. That's a second reset, and Snake, signs of life finally being showed. They get the team fight they want. Kid is gonna get slowed by the pillar. Crystal will chase him now for another kill as Bucca will collect. Blundra is still chasing now, but that's a dragon. Not yet, but four kills done for Snake.
Only Crystal getting caught out is really a way that Invictus Gaming can win a fight. Pillar of Ice, very smart in this situation, but no poke onto Kakao.
Didn't quite think about that synergy, but zoning people out for Tristana to do single target damage with Trundle, not too bad.
Tristana is super injured in this case, and look at the damage.
Ulti that coming through does miss there as it's flashed away. Flandre taking a bit too much damage as Ella gets eaten by a Flame Chomper. The Tide forced to flash away, though. Rookie coming in, and it's a big contest for IG, but Beast. Sorry, Kakao going to ulti defensively. Rookie moves it back in. Crystal almost goes down to Azir as Ella will fall, and Crystal's got to find a way back in, but he's getting zoned so hard by this Azir, and Flandre needs to chase him away. Trying to get the solo kill, does get it with the Tiamat active. Now's the time running away, but Bucca will chase him down. The Tide will stand his ground. Bucca will get the kill. Kid's gonna fall to Flandre, and the one-man army of the Trundle's going absolutely ballistic.
Yeah, Flandre's so tanky in the front line, even with multiple machine gun auto attacks, no one kill him. And Crystal's still alive.
Yep, Crystal gets the last kill. That's the ace completed by Snake as well.
5-1, and obviously a good luck charm for the team.
This is a 2v4 right now. Make it a 1v5 actually for Flandre, who's still alive. Now Crystal gonna come in. Rookie almost dead to just the Tristana autos. Kakao will zone them out with an auto, but Beast fairly tanky. Ulti comes through. That's going to force the rocket jump away for Triss. That will back away.
All positioned very aggressively. Still being able to reset and fights with such a squishy lineup. And it's Assassination Tristana coming
in. Yeah, Flandre and Crystal doing this again. Happy to 2v4 or 2v5 apparently in this game. As Flandre will take some pokes. Kakao will chuck a ward into the back. But Crystal going to join his team for Baron damage. And that Baron is dead. Almost sniped away by Kid. But Beast smites it away. And Flandre zoning the entire enemy team by himself. Crystal launches himself. And Shockwave gets the tie and kitties. As they go down to tie. Ultimate for the last second. Kid coming in, but Crystal lives to tell the tale. Rookie running rampant, gets caught by the scrying orb. Can't do anything, gets away. Will go down to about 3 shots from Crystal and Snake. They get the ace, the Baron, and IG surrender.
They have to surrender. The big talking point there, Pastry Time, is that in minigun form, you could not take down the Tristana as Jinx, because the lifesteal was so massive.